sa inyong lahat. Ito po si Dr. Jaime Sicarelis Jr., Dean ng CPU College of Agriculture, Resources, and Environmental Sciences. Sa ngayong araw po, in behalf na wala ako dito sa inyong harapan live, but this is the taping of our program now that will be showcasing about commercial production of Philippine native chicken. This is the task given to us by the Department of Culture to speak about on the investment forum for today's activity. So, ano po ba ang ibig sabihin ng Philippine native chicken? Now, pag sinabi natin po natin na Philippine native chicken, these are what we call the native fowl that can be found in the Philippines. They may not be indigenous. Iba kasi pag sinabi natin indigenous, dito mo lang makikita. But when you say about native chicken, it used to proliferate in the country for almost several decades and were able to thrive given the local conditions and local resources. Pag sinabi po natin ng local condition, na climatic condition, it refers on the siguro sa init, sa lamig, na they were able to survive and behalf of those climatic conditions and available local resources that can be found in this locality. So the common practice that we have known is that raisers are keeping native chicken because they wanted to have it to be the source of their food. Ito po kasi ang pinakamura na source ng itlog at saka karne sa mga locality natin, sa kabarangayan o di kaya sa Mabukirin, kung saan dito po natin makikita ang karamihan ng native chicken. And the technology being given to them or being practiced is what we call the backyard scale of production. Pag sinabi po natin backyard scale of production, ito po yung pag-aalaga ng manok na paunti-unti. Meaning that in every household, if there are about mga 10 to 20 hens or about paired with 2 to 5 roosters, no, that is what we call the common practice. Some other farmers are giving it with housing and supplemental feeding. But today we'll be discussing about the business opportunities of keeping this native chicken, particularly our native chicken. Iba kasi ang Philippine native chicken with the commercial native chicken. Yung tawag natin is pari native chicken. Now, when it's about pari native chicken, the other term for it is what they call the colored broilers. Pag sinabi po ating colored broilers, yung parang lumaki na kasing bilis ng broilers, kaya lang yung mga balahibo niya, it possesses what they call the colors. Now, it may vary from brick red or maybe itim or what other colors, but it is known as what they call the colored broilers. And they're commonly raised for dual purpose. When it's about dual purpose, it can be raised both for egg production and meat production. But today, I will be discussing more on the opportunities behind what they call the Philippine native chicken. So when we say about Philippine native chicken, there are two major groups of native chicken in the Philippines. We have what they call the larger genetic group and the smaller genetic group. When we say about larger genetic group, ito po yung mga lahi ng manok na katulad ng Basilan chicken. You have what they call the Parawakan or Palawan. Basilan can be found in Sambonga Peninsula. And right now, they're developing what they call the Sampin chicken. The Sampin chicken, that is what they call the Sambonga Peninsula chicken, originated from what they call purified out of the Basilan chicken. The Parawakan can be found in Palawan. And we have also what they call the Hulu chicken in Western Visayas. And we have what they call the Egon in Bicol region and the Huluano in Northern Luzon areas. So these are what they call the larger genetic group. They can grow as more than 1 kilogram in just a matter of maybe 2.5 months or even 3 months. Now, malaki po itong manok to and it is noted to become resistant to diseases. Ang isa lang sa mga consideration dito, it has what they call the tough meat. Medyo may katigasan yung karni ng manok na to. The other group is what they call the smaller genetic group. Ang smaller genetic group naman natin, now, we have what they call the Bisaya chicken of the Visayas and Mindanao area. These are what they call the group of native chicken that can be found in wider areas of regions in the Visayas and Mindanao. We have what they call the Tagalog chicken, or in Southern Tagalog. We have also what they call the Darag chicken. The Darag chicken of Panay Island is purified. It has what they call a dimorphism in terms of color. Kasi yung kulay ng inahin niya, we have what they call the pencil brown. While yung kanyang rotandang naman, you have what they call the pula-pulahin yung kulay. Now, what you have what they call a grayish to black shank color. Now, this is purified out of the Bisaya chicken in Western Visayas. We have also what they call the Banaba chicken. Found this is the native chicken of can be found in Batangas area. Na yung pinakakuan lang, we have what they call the spurs and the legs, both for male and female. We have also what they call the Camarines chicken. It is barred in color or bulik in kulay that can be found in Bicol area. We have also what they call the Bulinaw chicken in Pangasinan area. But yung pinakamarami in Tagalog or Luzon area is what they call the Manok Tagalog. So minsan merong joke dito na pag yung manok daw can be found in Visayas area, it is known as what they call the Manok Bisaya. But when it goes to Manila or to Luzon area, Tagalog speaking area, it becomes Manok Tagalog. So that is what they call the counterpart of the smaller genetic group of native chicken in the Philippines. Now, Central Philippine University is working on various researches on native chicken as early as 1990s. But we formalized or medyo malaki ang study na kinandak namin way back as early as 2002. We conducted studies from the market demand, production side, and other studies necessary to lead into what they call commercial production of native chicken. Yung pinakaiba ng CPU po over the other institution is that CPU is gearing on research on native chicken, but it is what they call in a full blast or a commercial scale, not what they call the backyard scale of production. Given that the condition, that the demand for native chicken all throughout the country keeps on increasing, pero yung problema natin is that in terms of the supply naman, parang hindi lumadami. As early as 1960s, the demand is as high as millions, but the and then it goes down a bit in 2013, yung recorded data, accumulated data for the whole country, the total demand for native chicken is about more than 230 million per year. Ang problema natin how this demand can be met, and it will be only confining ourselves in doing what they call the backyard scale of production, parang walang mayari sa atin in terms of raising the native chicken. So that is why we bank, the CPU bank on researches focuses in terms of commercial production. Pero sa ating pong taga pakinig o taga nandito po sa investment forum na to, ano ba sa inyo, sino ba ang CPU? Pag sinabi natin CPU po, that is known as what they call the Central Philippine University. Based on the data, yung pinakasentro daw ng Pilipinas can be found in us. I don't know how the Americans were able to determine why that the center of the Philippines can be found at Central Philippine University. Yung pinaka-common daw na central point ng Pilipinas can be found along our flagpole in the campus. CPU is one of the premier university in this country. We recorded as also noted to have what they call the number of academic department belonging in the Center of Excellence and Center of Development under the Commission of Higher Education. Na the College of Agricultural Resources and Environmental Sciences is ranked one of the university classified under the Center of Excellence. Actually, the Central Philippine University, this is the only university in the Western Visayas or relocated at Haro Ilo City that used to offer College of Agriculture within the city. So we have what they call also various facilities, and we have also farms in Leon and in Saraga where our laboratory and production product activities is being bring down. CPU, as an education institution, one of our pillar also is what they call in terms of the research. And this university is committed to help the Philippine education industry through scientific innovation. That is why that we conducted various researches. Researches focusing on the commercial production of native chicken. Now, we're not only raising chicken by the hundreds, but we used to raise native chicken by the thousands. To simulate really the industry is that twice that in behalf of the demand, in behalf of the claim of human distinctive taste, but why is that this kind of industry na hindi po makaboylo. So, native chicken as one of our banner program at CPU. We are also used to develop also technologies na yung isa kasi sa pinaka-consideration natin in terms of the raising native chicken is that this university used to bridge the gap between the raisers and the consumers. Bakit po? Sa katotohanan po, it is the middleman. The larger, the greater number of middlemen can be found on the center between the raisers and the consumers. That is why that parang lugi ata. Why? Because the trend is that in terms of the pricing of native chicken, mura ang bilihan ng manok doon sa part ng mga raiser, but when it reaches the consumers, sobrang mahal. So that is why that this university used or dream or is working on to bridge and how to bridge the gap between consumers and the raisers through the process known as what they call innovative production and marketing scheme. And we are doing it in this university para naman na mapataas yung kita ng raisers natin, ng mga farmers natin. At the same time, yung mga produkto naman dumating doon sa ating mga consumers will be more affordable on the part. And then, as note down, CPU is conducting researches as early as 1980s or 1990s. And we become seriously doing researches on native chicken than 2002, but in terms of really immersing ourselves in terms of researching native chicken, it was in 2012 where we started the simulation of the commercial scale of production. So that's how. So kunting natin pa 2012 to 2019, sa ngayon po, that is almost in 7 years. Now, the station or the CPU, research station for Philippine native chicken. This is one of the largest research station for Philippine native chicken all throughout the country. Now, way back then, and even up to now, we are raising not only hundreds, but then we are raising about 1,250 chickens. Inahinat lang yan. Hindi pa yan kasali doon yung tawag ito yung mga tandang at saka yung mga sisiw. That is why, based on experience, not only experience, but we coupled that also with what they call the science behind of raising native chicken in commercial scale. Now, what are the products and services that used to be developed in this station for that number of years of decades of conducting studies pertaining on native chicken? Iba kasi, if you are only conducting research for the sake of generating information, iba naman yung dating niya if we are conducting research, not only research, but we are integrating business out of research. Iba kasing usapan if just only to produce and produce knowledge and to produce information and produce information, then those information should be processed and narrow it down into a technology and being performed right in the station. Iba kasing usapan if the station is just only producing technology at saka those stations that really perform business out of the studies or out of the output that were conducted in there along with the implementation of the various researches being done in this station. So out of the number of years that we are dealing on researches, we develop various product and services. Kaya nga sabi nila the CPU research station for Philippine native chicken is noted to become as one-stop shop in terms of technology, in terms of services, and in terms of the products devoted solely for the upliftment of the Philippine native chicken industry. Kung sabihin natin, parang sabihin natin that this industry is in the infant stage. Actually, matagal na itong industry ito. The only thing is that when we are conducting researches, iba kasi yung perception ng researches na doing it on a commercial scale and doing business mismo nandoon sa research station. So, we tend to develop, we develop various products and services out of our researches in the station. So, to those who have not enough knowledge in terms of raising native chicken and commercial scales, now we are suggesting for you as a good reading material. Now we develop, or we have written, or we develop and package technology pertaining on commercial production of native chicken. Actually, this book can only be found or can only be purchased right at Central Philippine University. Now, ito pong book na to is pertinent on the commercial production of organic Philippine native chicken. So, lahat ng technology that we develop, no, and experience at the station is being, we develop it into packages of technology, and it is written in this book. Actually, the price of this book is about 2,500 with free shipping na po nationwide. So, if you have or if you would like to have a copy of this book, no, you can contact the number na written on the slide. No, importante kasi itong book kasi ito. Iba kasi yung ang perception natin if you try to implement the package of technology pertaining and package scale of production and doing it, no, raising a larger number of chicken, baka po delikado po. There are number and various institutions and individuals and OFWs that try to venture, no, on raising native chicken in commercial scale, but applying the technology, focusing on backyard, marami ponologi. At the start, maganda po yung operation, but as the number of years, no, tumatagal po, delikado po. The key problem always there is what they call the sustainability of operation. So right from this book, no, dito po sa loob nito, makikita nyo lahat, no, from the basic information in terms of economics. We have also breeding, no, housing and ranging areas, even the feed formulation. Yung isa po sa critical dito is what they call the feed formulation. Na so as po ngayon, sobrang taas po ng presyo ng ating commercial feeds, but in terms of the bilihan po, yung presyo po naman natin na native ay hindi po ganoon kataas po. Kaya nga pag tumaas yung presyo ng ating supplemental feeds, it will follow also what they call the production cost that will also likely to increase. And yung isa po dito is lahat ng feed formulation from the booster, starter, grower, and bidder formulation is written in this book. And the common cultural practices, sabi natin cultural practices, from day one hanggang po dumating doon po sa marketable age, is also written in this book. No? So makikita po doon anong gagawin mo when the chicks arrive in your project, no? And then up to the marketing age. Kasi yun po yung marketing age natin, it can be narrowed down even up to as less than 60 days. Na ganyan po native chicken natin, if only proper care and management can be done. Na that is a competitive one. The only thing is that palagi po natin iniisip na yung native chicken natin, masarap siya, pero gano, katagal po na alagaan. You're wrong. No, because in the station, we found out that it can even be reduced in less than 60 days. Kaya lang problema natin, if you'll be raising native chicken in less than 60 days, yung karne niya po hindi doon po ka-intact po. Na mabilis po siyang mabasag yung mga laman-laman sa loob niya. But when it comes naman po sa quality, it maintains. And we prepared for the marketing age. If you opted, for example, na kung saan po yung manok niyo, you want about 900 grams live weight. Kasi pag 900 grams live weight yan, aabot yan hanggang mga 75 to 90 days, no, given the technology that we adopted in station. But if you will be raising it on getting, for example, dress weight of 500 grams, mataas po kasi ang dressing percentage na native natin. That is an average of about 80%. Ibig sabihin, for 900 grams live weight na marketable live weight natin, yung kanyang dress weight niyan is aabot na mga 700 to 720. So, yung 900 grams natin na live weight, it can be extended no, from 75 to 90 days. It's just a matter on how, actually, kung tingnan po natin, if you want to adjust a growth of chicken, no, it may be adjusted in terms of the feeding and the management by itself. Now, in terms of that is the cultural practices and how to control infection diseases, we have also the section in that book known as what we call the plaque health management. Yung plaque health management naman natin yung nagay doon, tandaan po natin. Yung pinaka-critical in terms of raising native chicken is the breeder stocks. Make sure that your breeder stocks is properly vaccinated. Iba kasi yung usapan, if you only be vaccinated then, in organic parlance, vaccination is allowed as long as the diseases that you want to prevent or to control is prevalent in that kind of area. So, ibig sabihin na kung ano po ang sakit na manok na pinaka-prevalent sa lugar nyo, that is also the vaccine that you're going to use. Never use other vaccine na wala doon ang sakit na yan sa area nyo. Bakit? Ikaw mismo dala ng sakit mismo sa lugar nyo. So, plaque health management. Kung paano gamutin yung mga pinaka-common diseases. Inside that book written, what they call the various plant-based medication. Ang tawag namin doon is what they call the phytobiotics. So, when we say about phytobiotics, that is a plant-based extracts no, processed into either waste na kung saan no, it can be used to control or prevent infection of diseases. We have also written in that book no, the record-keeping and others. Maganda po siyang guide po sa to those who would like to venture on commercial scale of production. No, because it is a comprehensive book. Inside that book, it is equipped also with pictures no, for easy understanding. So, sa mga gusto po na mag-avail ng book na to, no, pwede nyo ilista yung pangalan nyo. No, hanapin nyo lang po dyan si Miss Dana Gabasa no, para po may ilista yung mga pangalan nyo at para may padala po sa inyo ang book na gusto nyo. If you want to have a copy of that book, remember that that book cannot be found in various bookstores. It can only be purchased right at Central Philippine University. Aside from this book as your comprehensive guide, what are other products that we can offer to the raisers? We have also what we call the mini cornmeal. Gaya ng sabi ko kanina is that the largest part of producing native chicken is what they call the use of supplemental feeds. Ang isa po sa consideration natin is that if we are going to have to raise native chicken commercial scale, ibig sabihin that we are not raising chicken here na kung saan konti. Based on experience that we have, if we'll be raising 100 hens na para po pang commercial scale, halos lugi ka. If you want break even now in terms of your operation, you can have at least mga 300 to 400 hens para yung operation mo in terms of cost associated no, mabilis mo na mabawi doon. Now, in terms of pinakamalaking gastos po doon sa pagagana manok, you have what you call the supplemental feed by itself. If you want to raise native chicken in a perilous condition, tandaan po natin. Yung isa sa consideration natin in terms of raising native chicken, sa isang inahin, yung area requirement po natin is about 110 square meter per hen. Ibig sabihin, if you have about 1 hectare, no, 10 square meter, ibig sabihin, you have going to raise 1,000. So, if you have half hectare, you have 500 hens. Ganyan po, kalawak ang kailangan nating lupain. In terms of growing native chicken, naman for market or intended for dressed native chicken, ang space requirement ng kada isang manok is what they call about 5 square meter per bird. However, the availability of supplemental feeds or what they call as cabinable feed resources in the area, it may be affected by the season and the topography in the flock size. Ibig sabihin, pag sinabi natin topography, iba kasi ang patoka na makita mo sa area na kung saan medyo doon sa hilly areas compared than those areas or we are raising chicken in the lowland areas. In terms of season, iba naman yung availability ng scavengeable feed resources during the rainy season at saka during dry season. But remember always that as your flock size, no, ibig sabihin ng flock size natin, habang dumadami yung manok natin, yung ability po ng scavengeable feeding sources ay bumababa po. That is why that the rule of giving supplemental feeding is very critical when you're raising native chicken in commercial scale. That is why that yung isa palagi doon is that if you want to raise native chicken in larger scale, ang isa problema mo if you're going to mix your own feeds, problema po palagi na associated is in terms of the equipment. Sabihin, sobrang mahal na equipment na kailangan natin dito if you're going to formulate our own feeds. Doon pa kayo nagkamali po. At Central Philippine University, we developed what they called a mini corn meal. Ibig sabihin ng mini corn meal na to po, this can be used in areas. It can use to mill corn, soya, and other grains. No? This is a cheaper version where you can make your own. If you have ever the 500 hands to feed lahat pati siso niya palakihin nyo, na doon pwede mo magamit to. We developed this one based on experience na mas mura po ang kainatnan ng investment cost in terms of what they call the mini corn meal. We try to put what they call the shifter kasi ang kailangan po natin is that during the milling process, yung malaking kernels niya, kung kailangan mo ibalik, you can have it be back at the corn meal no, para ma-adjust mo yung fineness no, or number of grits or the grit size no, na kailangan mo palabasin. Aside from the mini corn meal, no, as our banner project or as our banner product then, because in 2012, no, the Department of Science and Technology no, under the PICARD no, assigned as researchers, research pertaining and development of supplemental feeds. And out of that research in 2012, we were able to develop what they call the CPU feeds. Ang CPU feeds po, that is a scientifically studied formulated feeds for your native chicken. This is the first in the Philippines that is supplemental feeds na talagang para pa-native chicken. Ang formulation po niyan makikita po natin po sa book na sinasabi ko kanina, yung commercial production of Philippine native or organic Philippine native chicken. Aside from CPU feeds, ito po is pwede mo gamit ula agad-agad. We have also what they call the CPU feed premix. Ibig sabihin po ng CPU feed premix, sa paggawa po ng patoka, ang pinaka-critical po dito is not those feed stop na malakihan yung volume na nilagay po natin. Yung pinaka-critical doon is yung mga maliliit na o counting ingredient po. Ang talk po natin dito is what they call the premix. So, ang kailangan mo lang dito is about mga 2.5 to 3.2 kilograms per 100 kilogram of your supplemental piece that you are going to formulate on your own. Ito po kasi ang mga micronutrients and microminerals or microvitamins and minerals can be found in this feed premix. And aside from that, for example, in your area, murang mais, we are not suggesting to use this third product that we have. Kung mais logan nyo, sobrang mahal. But if your area, medyo mura yung mais natin, inyo, mabili dyan sa inyong lugar, you can use what we call the CPU-based mix feeds. Ang CPU-based mix feeds po, ito po ay from various type of classes of feeds. From booster, starter, grower, and even up to the breeder feeds na kung saan po. Ang kailangan mo lang dito is a simple way. For every 1 kilogram of CPU-based mixed feeds, just add 2 kilograms of milled corn. No, please have it po, milled corn po. Yung giniling po nyo na mais doon sa corn meal natin na gawin po nyo dalawa po. So, ibig sabihin na based on our computation, medyo may kamahalan per kilo yung base mix. But if you are going to have it be added with 2 kilograms of milk corn, mapamura po niya ang presyo po ng patuka nyo. And that is what they call the one way also of helping our raisers kung paano po natin mapababa yung cost of production of raising native chicken. And to those who would like to have it be fully organic, no, we also have what they call the CPU pathogenic feed additives. Ibig sabihin ng pathogenic feed additives, this is the mixture or combinations of various plant-based materials na ginagamit namin to be part of your feeds. kaya tag namin dito is phytogenic. Phyto by itself means it is plant-derived type of additives. So aside from the supplemental feeds na hindi po siya makumpleto, if in terms of sakit na mamanok nyo, no? Iba kasi yung usapan natin, hindi naman kasi lahat ng panahon po walang sakit manok. Ang kailangan po natin aside from the biosecurity, kaya nga sabi ko palagi sa nag-attend ng seminar namin dito at CPO, preferably if you are keeping native chicken in larger scale, traffic or control na the number of visitors visiting your places. Bakit? Di mo kasi alam yan kung saan ang galing yan. Pag di mo alam, what if these people are bringing some infections? So, delikado po sa manok nyo. So, kaya nga dapat na i-control natin ng konti. No, you should apply what you call the biosecurity. But along with the biosecurity, no, based on experience that we have in the station, na marami pong mga plant-based medication na halos mas effective pa nga compare natin with synthetic antibiotics or synthetic veterinary drugs. And we, based on the research that we have conducted and experience that we have in the stations, now we develop various products to cater this need. First, we have what we call the CPO phytobiotic tea. Ibig sabihin ng CPO phytobiotic tea, this is a tea form of phytobiotics. Ibig sabihin na ilagak mo lang konti kung paano mo pinipipel ang tea. Ganon din po ang gawin niyo po. It is being packed in a tea bag, no, para sa mabilisang gamit niyo if you want to have it. Aside from CPO phytobiotic tea, we develop also what we call the CPO phytobiotic tablets. No? It came from various combinations of elements that can be controlled or prevent by this kind of medications. And the other one, we have also what we call the CPU Phyto Dewormer Capsule. No? Ang binta po nito is if you want to control kasi yung mga entel parasites, no, we develop, no, this Phyto Dewormer. This is a plant-based Phyto Dewormer. Ito po ang mga medication na to, ito ang sumapadak na to po, is really developed out of the experience and researches that we conducted in the stations. Kaya nga sabi ko kanina, iba kasi yung usapan. Pag dumami yung manok po na nilagaan natin, here comes yung sakit po and others na kailangan po we should be innovative enough to develop certain product na kung saan mag-akpa doon. Yan kasi ang pinakalaking dagok po sa pag-alaga ng organic native chicken. Bakit? We have this kind of technology, but if we don't have any alternative medications na to make sure that it will not be treated with synthetic chemicals, doon po tayo mahirapan. Actually, the buyer is buying native chicken because they're believing it is free from synthetic chemicals. So that is why that in this station, we develop this various product, no, to cater the needs of the racers. Aside from the product that we develop, with numbers of years of experience that we have, paulit-ulit na nangyayari minsan, we tended to develop new innovations, so what they call innovations, and how to control or how to ease the problem. In terms of incubation po, native chicken is, we develop what they call the hatchery facility. So, pag sinabi po natin hatchery facility po, that is intended from the production of the old chicks. So, you need what they call the hatchery. In hatchery, incubation kasi po, may dalawang equipment na kailangan dyan. You have what they call the sitter and you have what they call the hatcher. Yung sitter po, doon po nalagay ang itlog for the first 18 days. And after 18 days, it will to 22 days, no, it will be transferred in the hatcher. Now, iba kasing operation in terms of sitter and the hatcher. All the operation, no, in this kind of sitter and hatcher, no, yung temperature, yung humidity, no, that is automatically controlled. Even yung turning ng egg, it is automatically controlled. In terms of the size of the capacity of your sitter and hatcher, based on experience that we have, na health-wise. Pag sinabi po natin health-wise, yung nag-alaga o nag-ooperate ng incubator nyo at saka hatcher. Pero probably, na kung if you want to have this kind of equipment, probably do not buy more than 500 capacity na egg na sitter. Bakit? mas mabilis i-manage cleanliness wise. At saka ang importante doon is that yung pine feeders, ang pine feeders, lalo na po nasa hot sun. Pag napisa kasing sisaw dyan, na when you are going to get the sisaw, na the DOC after 22 days, yung pine feeders due to hot sun, lumilipad kasi yan, pumapasok hanggang sa ilong ng ating tauhan. So personal, make sure that maliliit siya po, kung maliliit po siya, mabilis siya i-maintain o i-manage. And aside from the hatchery facility, no, critical kasi ang facility and equipment when it comes to raising native chicken on commercial scale. We have also what they call the housing facility. Now, this station is helping raisers on how to design and fabricate what they call the housing facility pertinent to your need to produce native chicken. Yung housing po natin, we have for the breeders, we have for the brooders. Yung brooders po kasi, breeder po kasi, critical po. Now, we have some consideration in terms of the Filipino standard of fabricating the housing for native chicken. So, we can help you to design the housing, the housing pertinent in your locations. Iba kasing design when you are developing housing ng breeder in the hilly area compared than in terms of the flat area. Now, we have also for brooding. Na isa po sa pinakamalaking gastos po in terms of the brooder is in terms of the electricity for brooding. So we design or we develop housing designs na yung cost associated with electricity mapababa po natin during the brooding. And we have also what they call the grow out facility. When it's about grow out facility, ang brooding po sa native chicken is different from the commercial breed kasi sa commercial breeds it may last for about 2 weeks, but for native chicken, no, it even be lasting about 30 days. Yun kasi ang pinaka-critical na edad ng mga natin na dapat it should be properly housed, otherwise mortality. Raising native chicken in previous condition, mortality by itself, no, is more than 40%. More than 40%. That is why na kung sabihin po natin na yung raising native chicken in previous condition, mura, try nyo ikwan, try nyo i-compute from the mortality to be included in the cost, the supplemental feeds, the labor that you have, halos mas mahal ang katumbas niyan if you are going to account all those things. Kaya nga, yung focus na researches ngayon for some institution is that on how to reduce mortality. How to reduce mortality? Some of the consideration there is in terms of your housing facility by itself, the housing facility and the production protocol that you are using. Ang isa pa sa consideration natin in terms of we have what they call the hatchery facility and we have what they call the designing and fabrications of the housing facility. The third one, na very critical in terms of commercial scale production, is in terms of collecting excreta or the waste product of your or the excreta of your native chicken. So in the brooding stage, mahirap kasi pag sobrang dami if you are going to have the rice or the breeding materials. Actually, if you're raising only by the hundreds, walang problema yan. But in terms ngayon po, halos ang rice hull po ngayon, na medyo kaunti na, Bakit? Majority of the rice hull produced in the rice mill, ginagamit siyang panggatong doon sa mga, tawag dito natin, sa mga rice dryer. So, at CPO, we develop what they call an automated excreta collecting, whereby we're using what they call conveyors, and it is automated. So meaning mayroong set of time na siya na siya mismo kusang loob na gumagana para siya mismo mag-collect ng iskrita ng iyong manok. And that is one way and how that we can help to minimize the odor, possibly eliminate the odor in the housing. Kasi po ang isa po sa mga nakita naming kadalaginanan kung bakit mataas yung mortality natin inside the housing, it is because of the accumulation of ammonia in the housing. It is more of what they call the management practices. Kaya nga, to ease the problem in terms of those ammonia, in terms of tauhan, kasi po, as the number of chicken that you are raising, dumadami po, a number of personnel that you are needing is also dumadami po. So that is why we develop this kind of facility para po mapagaan yung pag-alaga ng manok natin yan sa respective areas niyo po. And aside from that, we have also catering what we call based on experience that we have, buying existing equipment pertaining to pin milling, ang problema namin po is the wear and tear. Wear and tear. Pag sabi natin wear and tear po, maintenance-wise. So that is why that in the station, we develop our own equipment in terms of the pin milling. Sabi daw doon that if you want to put up a pin mill, no, you should prepare what they call the capital investment of more than millions of capital. But for us at Central Philippine University, no, we develop what they call pin mill equipment. Na kung saan, mura lang. No, we tend to develop, this is what they call the community-based pin milling. We develop our own equipment, maintenance-wise, and fuel consumption utilization po. Mas kaunti po sa ang fuel consumption niya, and it can mill by the tons. So, we develop what they call a heavy-duty no pin mill equipment for this purpose. Yung pin mill na to po, it can produce as many as 5 to 10 tons of beads per week. Yan yan po kadami. It depends on the available. Ang operation po natin dito is less than 8 hours per day. No, isang tauhan lang kailangan mo. Or if you have other person during milling, no, the isa o dalawa lang kailangan mo dito to produce this kind of bullion beads. Ang ginagamit namin po dito, we try to promote what they call the community-based feed milling. Ano ba ang pinag-iba ng community-based feed milling? Iba po ang commercial. If you want to engage really in commercial, sobrang dami ng capitalization na kailangan mo. But in this kind of technology that we develop, kaunti lang. Actually, the cost associated here, na because you're only using what they call scrap materials in the development, halos if you're going to entail all the cost, na that is, the investment is less than 500,000 for you to produce about 5 to 10 tons of supplemental beads per week. So this is ideal na equipment for community-based bead milling. This is one way and how, na kung saan po sa area po natin, if it is a corn belt area, na kung saan marami pong mais din sa area nyo, and you can have it be processed into beads, the better it will be. Bakit? Pag ibinta po nyo natin yung mga mais natin doon sa mga middleman po, sobrang baba. But if you're going to convert that into supplemental feeds, ibig sabihin, you are putting what they call a value-adding to your product. So at CPU, no, we develop this kind of equipment based on resources that we have para po makita natin ang kinakailangan po ng mga committee natin when it comes to formulating their own pitch, and the CPU is very much willing to share this technology among those technology takers that would like to tap with us. And aside from that, we have also what they call the facilities equipment needed for as an input for your commercial production of chicken. We have also what they call the main products of researchers. Kaya nga sabi ko kanina that possibly that we are the only the station that we are only conducting research here, but we are integrating business out of research that we have. Na kaya nga iba ang operation namin. In terms of the products, na main product, if your problem is about breeder stocks, this station is really promoting what they call diversity, genetic diversity. That is why we used to grow here now hulu and the Bisaya chicken. One from the larger genetic group and the other is from the smaller genetic group. Yung Bisaya kasi smaller genetic group, ang hulu po is a bigger genetic group. We are also selling what they call the on a tawag natin dito is in terms of on a dapat po sabi contact nyo muna yung station namin na in terms of WBT of these stocks. So we have also selling what they call breeder stocks. Ang breeder stocks na to po is we really develop them to adjust even in a harsh condition. No, kailangan kasi po to, hindi laki si lahat ng condition na pupunta ng breeders, ng mga breeders na develop namin yung station can be favorable to them. But there may be some areas na kung saan medyo critical po. So that is why that we develop no these stocks intended talaga for breeding. So selection process, it starts from the egg up to the time when it is now ready to become a breeder stock. Tandaan po natin, if you want to raise native chicken, yung breeder stocks natin is very critical. And remember always that yung breeder stocks natin particularly yung mga inahin natin, na it should only up to 2 years of production. Alright, why? Because after 2 years, the egg production will start to decline. And aside from the breeder stocks, we have also what they call the DO chicks. So, ang DO chicks na to po, you can also acquire with us. Now, this is out of the BCA and Hulu. And we are also selling what they call the hardened chicks. Ang hardened chicks po na to, that is aging about a month old. 30 days old na binibinta namin as the hardened chicks. Ang purpose kasi nito kasi if you are not well-versed in terms of raising native chicken and you'll be starting on the old chicks, mataas kasi ang mortality sa CCU. Unlike po the hardened chicks na kung saan medyo malaki na sa ng konti. And we have also, we are not selling the grow-out na 3 months old, but we are selling what they call the dress native chicken. So right now, this station right now, we are simulating now na kami na pata dito si Lou, we will be able to bring about more than 1,000 native chicken doon mismo sa dressing plant na try namin for what they call the dressing. So we have also what they call the fertilized table egg. Ang fertilized table egg na to medyo may kalaitan to because this is what they call the discarded egg. Actually, fresh from the farm, kaya lang na hindi sa pasok doon for incubation. Bakit? During incubation po, yung may itlog na less than 39 grams po, kinakal namin yan, pinipili namin, pinapalabas namin kasi yung itlog na maliit po, it will produce smaller chicks. Pag smaller yung CCU po, yung survival rate masyadong mababa. At saka in terms of tawag dito yung paglaki po, medyo mahina po maglaki. So ganyan nga sabi natin na if you want, iba kasi ang target natin if you are raising that in commercial scale, iba ang usapan natin than raising native chicken solely for household consumption. And we have also some product, it is what they call a marinated chicken. So ang marinated chicken naman ito, na this is ready to cook na. So ibig sabihin, na if you want to cook native chicken, na organically raised or synthetic or chemical pre na pag-alaga ng manok, na you can have what they call the marinated one. And aside from those products, the equipment, the facility equipment, and the product as native chicken, we use also to offer what they call the various services. Now, so we say about various services po. Ito po ang mga services na pinatimibigay sa mga would-be raisers ng native chicken and commercial scale. We have what they call the personalized training. We say about personalized training. Ano pag naiba nito? This is the first in the Philippines. This station is the first in the Philippines to offer what they call the personalized training. Pag sabi pa ating personalized training, ibig sabihin po, one-on-one discussion po tayo in terms of raising native chicken. Iba kasi ang usapan, if you are raising native chicken, the better first before you putting up all your investments, dapat equip mo na yung sarili mo. Remember that we are putting our hard-earned money in this kind of project. Mahirap kasi na yung ginagawa natin is more on what they call the trial and error. Ibang usapan. 1,000 is 1,000. So make sure to equip first yourself. So we offer what they call the personalized training. We have also what they call the on-the-job immersion program. Ang personalized training, it can be either for the owner and the caretaker, but preferably the owner, and maybe before the year end, we'll be offering 2 classes of personalized training. We have what they call the personalized training for the owner and personalized training for the caretakers or what they call the farm personnel. We have the other project known as what they call services, known as what they call the on-the-job immersion program or what they call the OGIP. Ang OGIP na to po is really intended for the farm personnel that will do what they call the hands-on operation. Because in the OGIP, it is more of what they call the on-the-job immersion, meaning the hands-on training po to. No, hands-on. So in terms of the lecture, kaunti lang, but the personnel that you will be sending to us will be directly immersed in our project and teach them on how to operate the whole total operation of raising native chicken. And from time to time, now we are also offering what they call the seminar or what they call the training. So in our page na Philippine Native Chicken, na ipakita ko sa inyo sa pinakadulo mamaya, na you can contact us. No? We are conducting series of trainings, but this training, anong pinakaiba ng training na to? This training is a specialized training on commercial scale of production. So ibig sabihin na lahat ng topic ko na tinatakal dito it is more or what they call the commercial scale. Ang kagandahan nito is that after the training, no, you have will be given a chance to visit our station para po makita nyo actual operation ng manok. That is why that the training that we're conducting, again, that is all Iloilo based. Bakit po? Lahat po ng facility dito and equipment is located in Iloilo. Mahirap kasi na if we keep on discussing and discussing about commercial scale of production of chicken, na wala po tayong pakita. Kaya nga, pasensya na po sa mga gusto mag-seminar. The lot of invitations for us to conduct seminar in Luzon and Mindanao. But sorry to say po, again, we are Iloilo based. Now, we encourage na kung if you really want to learn about native chicken, please na attend our training at Iloilo because our facility is located in this place. And aside from that, we have also what we call for the institutions. Now, we are also offering what we call as technology provider. So, ibig sabihin, na for example po sa mga institution ng governmental organization or governmental organizations that would like to avail our services, now we're also offering what they call the known as what they call technology providers. Ibig sabihin, we can provide the necessary technology na kinakailangan nyo para sa community na kung saan doon kayo tumatrabaho. That is one way and how we can help the different institutions na kung saan po makatulong po tayo sa community in raising native chicken and commercial scale. Those are what we call the different services that we offer at Central Philippine University Research Station for Philippine Native Chicken. So halos lahat-lahat nanto, it is not because of what we read, but it is supported with science and experience and the activity that we are doing for number of decades right now at Central Philippine University. Now, ang tanong ngayon, bakit CPU? Why CPU Research Station for Philippine Native Chicken? Tandaan po natin. We started it as a livelihood. Ibig sabihin po, based on studies conducted, follow-up studies conducted, now way back in 2010, almost 15% of the household expenditure in the rural areas is contributed na by native chicken. Ibig sabihin po, from ulam, hanggang gift, hanggang po pambenta, pambenta po, native chicken po, ang contribution niya in the total household expenditure from the meat to the egg, that is about 15%. Isipin po natin yan. That is why that many literatures claim that raising native chicken is an integral component of farming system in the Philippines. 15% contribution is great. Now, aside from that, CPU is looking at as a livelihood. Second is that we can keep on innovation. Kaya nga sa mga pupunta sa amin dito, sa mga tagatapang kilig po ng Philippine Native Chicken, ng CPU Philippine Native Chicken, halos kung makita pa nyo, every year, there is, we keep on innovating something. Changes happens. Bakit? That is based on experience and based on science. That is why we keep on updating or innovating our facilities equipment to fit in with the requirement of keeping native chicken in larger scale. Otherwise, kasi if we will be stagnant in terms of operation, the housing person, iba kasi ang design ng housing, speaking about backyard, raising only less than 100 than keeping native chicken by the thousands. Iba. That is why that we keep on innovating something to fit in really with the requirement that we have. And the other one is what we call dedication and experience that we have. Dedications in the sense that these stations, in behalf of the other opportunity, we are still dedicated with our slogan, helping the Philippine native chicken industry to scientific innovations. We are a specialized stations on researches on Philippine native chicken. So, lahat ng researches namin dito, kaya nga sabi nila, the CPU Philippine native chicken is a one-stop shop when it comes to technology, package of technology in terms of the equipment and facilities and even up to the marketing and processing of native chicken. Now, we are specializing on native chicken. So, the dedications that we have on the kinds of studies and experience that we have is to guarantee that we are going to the track of commercialization. And beside with it, why is that the innovation at CPO is prerequisite done? It is because we work with other experts. we are not only doing it because sabihin natin na kami yung station, lahat ng galing nandito sa amin, but we are also working on the various experts from the various disciplines. Anong pong target natin dito? Ang pinaka-goal ng project na to is that probably time will come na if we'll be keeping chicken by the thousands, but we are only employing na minimal number of personals. Bakit? As the number of personal increases, magiging problema mo po yan. So one way on how to reduce the number of labor is in terms of making our operation to be more on what they call the automated mode. That is why that right now in the station, we are now planning to develop a museum of technology. Now hoping that before the year end, now we can put up this museum of technology. That is from the time we started the commercial scale operation way back as early as 2012 technologies up to the present will be showcased now in our Saraga Farm, CPU Saraga Farm station. And we'd like to invite you all to visit our station by the time come para makita nyo po on how we innovate something from 2012 to 2019. And the other one is that why CPU Preventive Chicken? We work with investors. We work with investors. Ibig sabihin po, now we have what they call a periodic meeting with our technology takers. Bakit po? Ano po ang purpose niyan? Ang purpose niyan is that na para malaman namin is that why na yung industry itself, ano lang common problem na nag-occur along the way as the implemented project. Kahit po sino po sa atin siguro, nakita po natin, doon ang kagandahan ng Tip Chicken. But the questions right now is that how many of those invested were able to sustain their operations. Kaya nga, we try to engage or to immerse ourselves with the investors by themselves. Usap-usapan, kwentuhan, ano ba may tulong na station, ano ba common problem that they have, na kung saan yung station po makatulong. Ang pinaka-goal natin ito is a sustainable livelihood. Sustainable livelihood. Otherwise kasi pag walang sustainability po to, hanggang kwentuhan lang tayo. Mahirap kasi ng kwento na walang kwentahan. And aside from it, from investor, we're also working with farmers. Now, right directly in the field, we immerse ourselves in the field to really determine and how we can help to develop something from the station na kung saan yung native chicken industry will prosper in its operation and to meet with the increasing demand. Masakit po isipin po na in 2013, the demand of the country is about 230 plus million heads of native chicken, but even right now, it could not be supplied. Ang kagandahan po ng station na to is that aside from what we have mentioned, we have what we call the R&D component, the R&D team. The R&D team that we have, kung may problema pa makita during the operation, it is being conducted by a series of researches. The involvement of the faculty and staffs, and students of this college that work for the Philippine Team Chicken. So yan ang ibig sabihin na sabi natin na innovation na is keep on moving in this institution because of the R&D team that we have. Yung sa industry po kasi ang pinakamagastos na bahagi po is the R&D component. Otherwise kasi pag magiging contento lang tayo kung ano ang nandoon ngayon, yung competition kasi in the market is alive. Ibig sabihin that the R&D component must be implemented so that whatever the problems na innovations can be took place na para po ang magiging project natin magiging competitive. And beside of it, we are proud to say that in this station, we are not only here intending to develop production technology but even along the value chain. Pag isipin value chain natin o supply chain natin from the input until it reaches what they call the table of the racers, of the consumers pala. Now, that is very critical kasi. So that is why that we try to even to immerse ourselves in terms of the dressing plant and storage and others in the processing. Kaya ang masabi natin is that from farm to table activity that we are doing at the station. That is what they call the commitment of this institution. We are true to our slogan that we are helping the Philippine chicken industry through scientific innovation and we are bridging the gap between the racers and the consumers through innovative production and marketing. Now, who are our enablers? Alam po namin that we cannot do this alone. without the help of our enablers. Ibig sabihin ng enablers natin, yung sumusuporta sa amin to do this one. And we'd like to thank this institution for helping us, for the trust that they are giving to us in doing this activity. Alam namin po, sobrang bigat nito, kaya nga minsan, will be misinterpreted by the others. But I would like to correct these things. Iba kasi ang usapan if the station will only doing researches to produce technology and give it to the farmers. Iba din ang usapan if the station is doing research and putting that into business. No, kaya nga, the investment that the enablers giving to us, we try to make use it as a seed money to do something para to help this Philippine native chicken industry. First, we have what we call our institution. The mother institution that we have, the Central Philippine University. No, I am glad the research team of Philippine native chicken is glad to the CP administration for giving us the fund. Alam niyo po, when we started activity po pertaining to native chicken, in commercial scale of production as early as 2002, the university is always giving us the fund. Kahit na kaunti-kaunti lang, alam niyo po, when we started researches on native chicken, we started with a research fund of about 50,000 per research. Ganyan po kalaki po ang investment na ginagawa namin doon way back in 2002. But as the scope of the research tumataas po, the university is very much willing to invest on the sense. We'd like to extend our thank to the CPO administration, either our board of trustees, chairman, Attorney Bon Lobel Bidona, and our CPO president, Dr. Chudorce Robles, for giving us the opportunity banking this kind of research undertakings under the Philippine Native Chicken. At saka yung isa po na makipong utang na loob namin in CPU, that is why that we are true to our commitment, is the Department of Agriculture. Now, as early as 2012, the regional field office 6 of the DA is giving us fund for this undertaking. That is headed then by the regional district director, Larry Nacionalis, and the regional technical director for research, Dr. Joyce Windham, for the trust and confidence then. Alam niyo po, in 2012, minsan po may mga problema kami na as we go along on the process, the DA is always there to support us. And right now, since 2013-14, we are glad to be one of the partner research institution now by the Bureau of Agricultural Research, Bureau of Agricultural Research, whereby it giving us the plan toward what they call development of packages of technology for organic production of native chicken in commercial scale. So that is why we keep on doing this one with our enablers. Kasi nakita po natin, there are a lot of research agenda in the country na pertinent on the utilization of native chicken. Maraki po ang demand. The only problem is that on how to do it in commercial scale na kung saan it will also matches with the requirement of the market. And we're also glad to the Department of Science and Technology for initiating the fund that we developed by the CPA feed mill along with the Commission on Higher Education for the development po ng curricula for native chicken. The Central Philippine University College of Agriculture, Resources, and Environmental Sciences as a Center of Excellence for Agriculture Education is tasked by the Commission on Education to develop a specific curricula intended for Philippine native chicken. And right now, we develop group of OFWs and investors under the banner name. Now we have what they call the logo known as what they call the Philippine native chicken. In terms of the experiences directly from the field, experience of investors is being considered and brought to us and the station to work into something that is greater to help this kind of industry. Those are what they call our enablers and let at least farmers na in the field where we expose na sobrang dami po nila po na hindi po namin maibigay lahat-lahat, but we are glad to those individuals or group na hindi ko masabi lahat dito for helping us to become a specialized station on Philippine native chicken. Now, ang tanong ngayon na ano bang basihan namin when we do this kind of undertakings? First, we do it in what we call a sequential mode. we considered the value chain analysis of the various regions on pertaining on native chicken. Ang problema po natin is that why is that native chicken keep on increasing, the demand is keep on increasing, but the supply is very limited. It is because what we found out is that the technology developed at the station, it does not match with the requirement of the consumers in terms of meat quality and in terms of the need of the raisers. That is why in this station, ginagawa namin ang paraan, doing one job, na kung saan masagot mo na requirement ng raisers mo, masagot mo pa ang kinakailangan ng consumers mo. Why? Based on existing studies, it shows that survival rate of native chicken is lower. And that is true. Based on a study we conducted, production studies as early as 2003 and follow-up in 2010, it shows that the mortality of native chicken under the full clearance condition, under the pill condition, na it may be as high as 60%. We just narrowed down into an average of about 45%. Ganyan po kadami yung mortality natin. Marami yung sisiyo mo. Ang problema mo naman is that in terms of pagpunta doon sa bintahan. Secondly, raisers wanted that the native chicken can be raised in maybe limited time or shorten the growing period. It does not necessarily mean na pababaan natin to become comparable with the broilers. Iba kasi ito natin po, iba yung market ng native chicken natin with the broilers. Kaya nga, dapat na pababaan. Bakit? Kulang isa ko pang attendee in my seminar coming from Mindanao, sabi niya daw, it took almost 9 months bago niya ibenta manok niya weighing about 1 kilo. Pag ganyan katagal po, investment-wise, we need the return to income. Kaya nga, in a station, we were able to have it be narrowed down into 3 months weighing almost 800 to 900 grams. You can have it if you want a dressing weight about 500 grams. No, you can have it even to 2 months. Kaya lang problema natin, yung karne niya po, hindi po ganun ka-intact po. We need to have it at least mga 75 to 90 days. Ganyan po. Now, on the other hand, yung ating consumers po, they wanted native chicken na kung saan, they wanted a more tender and juicy meat. However, if the raisers would like to raise native chicken in a prince condition, tandaan po natin, habang lumalawak yung lalakaran ng manok natin, yung meat po niya, yung muscle meat niya po, tumitigas yan. So that is why that if you want a tender and juicy meat, restrict the movement of chicken. Pero that is not necessarily mean that you are going to have it raised na in 1 square meter, in 1 square foot, you can have at least 35 chicken. That is not what I mean. Well, probably po, ilimit mo natin movement niya. Ibig sabihin po, huwag natin pagalain halos sa buong farm. If you want the chicken na kung saan to have a tender and juicy meat. Pangalawa po is in terms of consistency of the meat, taste and quality. Yung manok po natin, pag pinapagalaw yung manok natin po, try po niya. Yung manok po, ang lasa ng manok during rainy season compared to the dry season is different po. Different. Bakit? Iba kasi tutuka niya. Kaya nga, if you want the taste of the meat to be consistent, dapat you must offer what you call supplemental feeds. And the distinctive taste of native chicken will come if yung supplemental feeds natin, that is, will be made up of about various several feedstock. Now, other one is that stability of supply. Supply po, kaunti pong supply. How can we cater the demand of the market kung supply po naman natin sa market po is kaunti. That is why that we should do it in a sense na kung saan po, we should do it in a commercial scale. That is why we are working to answer the problem of the raiser at the same time meeting the requirement of the market. That is how this undertaking at CPU is being done. And looking at the value chain, now various problems can be identified as seen in your screen. From the input, production, trading, processing, distributing, and even up to the final sale. That is where we anchored all our undertakings at CPU and how to help this native chicken industry. Now in terms of our organizational chart, again, we are under the leadership of our university president, and this station is overseen by the two BP. We have the BP for Finance and Enterprises in the business side of our operation, and in terms of research operation that we have under the BP for Academic Affairs. Now, what are the risks associated in raising Philippine TBCK and commercial scale? First, tandaan pa natin, do not venture this kind of business if you yourselves is not equipped. Bakit po? Tandaan po, ang pera po na inibis natin dito is a hard-earned money that we have. Equip yourself first before investing your money. Pangalawa po, hire knowledgeable personnel. Minsan po, ang iniisip po natin, if you are the OFW professionals, na minsan ba tayo dapat na yung nag-aalaga naman natin, mga mag-anak natin per se. But make sure that the person that is directly doing what they call the dirty job for us is knowledgeable to that activity that we have. And the third one is the technical support. Tandaan po natin technical support, that is very critical. Otherwise kasi information derived from various sources or literature, maganda po yan. But as we go along with the project that we have, na yung problema po, nandoon palagi yan. So better to have what I call the technical support, na kung saan po nyo makukuha po yan. Na in various areas, in various ways. Na CPU extending our support. Later on, I will showing you the different media where you can contact us if you have some problems pertaining on raising native chicken. Source of inputs is also very critical. Quality inputs po. Ngayon po, na sobrang dami na ng social media, sharing various products, but make sure that if you will be getting some of these inputs, make sure that you can acquire it directly from a reliable source. Tandaan po natin that we are producing a premium product. That is why if we're producing premium products, make sure that there is what they call the price and market support. Iba kasing usapan, ganito yung demand kasi, but what is very critical, I think, is the price. Ibang usapan, ganyan, karami yung kailangan niya, but if the price will not meet your own, doon tayo malulugi. It's very critical. Kaya nga, the price and market support is very critical. Given all this other problem that is can be mentioned because of the limited time that I have now in this investment forum, considering all the premises that I mentioned earlier to this person, actually we are now doing what they call the simulation on what they call the innovative production and marketing scheme. This is more of what they call the venture first. We're not yet ready to have it be done in commercial scale, but hoping that this can be fully materialized given experiences and given the problems that we encounter. Na ito po ang tag namin dito is Innovative Production and Marketing Scheme. This is still on the infancy stage of operations, but hoping that maybe by the year 2020, now we can have this one be fully implemented. This is one way on how to help our OFWs, professionals, and others, or even retirees, na kung saan po you don't have the pressure of time, but you have the amount of money to invest. In this way, na yung preliminary activities dito po is that the operation of your farm will be the one who will be operating your farm, and what you'll be only contributing is in terms of the investment. Kaya lang po, hindi pa ganoon siya pro-ripe, and I would like to encourage you all, if you have the access to the various e-platform, electronic platforms, you can follow us at the Philippine Native Chicken. Na, marami pong Philippine Native Chicken po sa Facebook po. Makikita po nyo, try to look on what they call the logo. Now that is showing the chicken and the logo, combination of the logo of chicken and the Central Philippine University. Now, makikita po nyo sa Facebook page, yan po ang page namin po, na kung saan you can ask questions, you can send us messages, you can even browse our page for various updates of the technologies. We have also what they call the Twitter account, na you can also see some of the photos of the technology that we develop in the station. Now, iba kasi ng usapan, pag makita mo kasi yung directly from the photos na kung saan po, pili nyo po makikita yan sa Twitter account namin na as seen in your screen, na tingnan po nyo yung page na yan, please visit the Twitter, na please follow us, no, even in the Facebook. You can follow and like our page, no, para if then we have what we call the updates, mabilis na pin sa news feed nyo. And we have the latter one, if you want the video documentations, no, of the best technologies and seminars that we have, no, you can visit our YouTube channel. No, hanapin nyo lang po, ang pangalan ko po, nandoon po yun sa YouTube. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more information. So, kung meron po kayong katanungan, na you can directly connect us with that various social media page, and you can also get, no, some contact with Miss Danagabasa na nandoon mismo sa inyo po. You can get some contact number there para po makakonnect po kayo sa amin dito sa Central Philippine University po. Again po, we'd like to extend our gratitude to the DAE AMAS, no, for providing us this opportunity, no, na kung saan po ma-relay po namin yung technology na generate namin dito at Central Philippine University Research Station for Philippine Native Chicken. I would like also to ask for apology na hindi po ako makapunta personal because of some of my commitment over here, emergency commitment at the university. But as a promise, now we are extending technology. Please connect us with various platform that I presented na kung saan po in some other ways we can help you in raising native chicken. Happy native chicken farming to all of you. Again, good day and thank you.